What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So I'm just pulling some cards and get a message out for y'all. I definitely do hope the message resonates, and I definitely do hope the messages are useful for you guys, okay? And with that being said, we're just gonna jump right into it, all right? I get some messages too. Right off the bat, you got the Knight of Wands coming out, and you also do have the Three of Wands. You got the Ten of Cups coming out as well. You also have the Seven of Swords coming out. You got the Four of Wands. You got the Nine of Cups. You got the Guide, and you also do have the Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, and you got the King of Swords at the bottom, and it is in reverse. You have someone not wanting you to be, like, comfortable, and I feel like, especially with this Guide, of course it could be your intuition, especially if... you do like believe in God, you do believe in spirit guides. This, you were being guided out of a situation that was just unfulfilling. It doesn't seem like it is a love relationship, but with the Ten of Cups and with the Knight, you were comfortable with wherever this was, wherever you were at, whatever this relationship was with this Four of Wands. What's this Four of Wands? Yeah, you got the Four of Cups coming out. Something did not go the way you planned. You didn't get a certain outcome that you thought you were gonna like get. What's this Guide card? Yeah, you got the Eight of Pentacles with the Two of Swords. And they've seen how hard you were working for something to like come out or like go in your favor. What's this Ace of Pentacles? And if you were wondering why, like, you didn't get something or, like, some, like, what was the cause? Something just wasn't for you. Like, a situation just wasn't for you. I feel like you were put in a certain situation. Of course, I'm going to get some more cards. Because with the Star for the Ace of Pentacles. Hey. What's this Nine of Cups? Yeah, you got the Nine of Pentacles coming out as well. 99 can be significant. 44 can even be significant. Because you were in a situation or surrounded like around people that like didn't see your worth. They were choosing not to see your worth either. What's this Seven of Swords? Like you were placed in a certain situation to like heal someone or like a group of people. And with the Two of Cups, for the Seven of Swords, these people, they didn't want to grow, they didn't want to heal. What's the Seven of Swords with the Two of Cups? And these could be friends as well. Colleagues even with this Eight of Pentacles, Two of Swords. So these are people that you were supposed to help and heal. Yeah, with the Queen of Swords. These people were stuck in their ways. Could be a Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. You're some sort of like teacher. You are this guy, possibly. Or you at least act as if you are a guy. What's this Two of Cups? I'm sorry, this Ten of Cups. Yeah, you got the Eight of Wands. Like, you have the power to, like, relay healing messages with this Eight of Wands with the Ten of Cups. Like, you were meant to heal, like, a large amount of people. What's this Ten of Cups with this Eight of Wands? Literally, with the Five of Cups. People who are, like, sad, going through things. People who are possibly, like, depressed. You were supposed to, like, uplift, heal. Change, like, the energy from, like, a negative to a positive. What's this Three of Wands? Literally, you have the World. Someone's gonna get, like, plastered for something in a good way, of course. Yeah, with the Six of Swords, it's coming. You're being guided to whatever this is. Like, somebody's going to be, like, if not, like, famous, very, very popular for some sort of, like, technique that they use to, like, help heal people. And it definitely does feel like it's through, like, the speech. Like, someone's voice is very powerful. Someone's aura, someone's energy. Like, it's very strong. It's felt. What's this Knight of Wands? And that's why in a lot of situations... Never mind. What's this Knight of Wands? Yeah, you got the Wheel of Fortune. You got the Destiny card with this Knight of Wands. I want to say keep pressing forward. What's this Wheel of Destiny with the Knight of Wands? Literally with the Page of Wands. And you got the Two of Wands. Yeah, you have to believe in yourself. Cause with this, hold on. With the Knight of Wands, you got the Wheel of Destiny. The Page of Wands to the Two of Wands. You were chosen to, like, deliver some sort of message. Or do some sort of, like, job, but it's something regarding, like, some sort of message, and you were chosen to do whatever line of work this is. I'm gonna use a different deck, because I feel like there's so much more in this deck is not trying to tell me everything. So what's this Two of Wands? What's the Two of Wands? Yeah, you got the Four of Cups. 444 could be significant. What's this Four of Wands to the Four of Cups? You have the Four of Wands. You had the Four of Cups and the Four of Wands coming out for the Four of Cups and the Four of Wands. Do not miss your blessing trying to appease or, like, tie yourself to, like, or, like, to impress. Someone is supposed to act as, like, a guide. Someone is different, uniquely different, and you are supposed to be that way. You were born that is a Lady Gaga born that way? I believe it is, because you were chosen. You are not like of people. People are supposed to reject you, honestly. People are supposed to look the other way because you come with an energy of, like, you come with healing energy, and it's felt, and you could fit, and sometimes you could question it, especially if, yeah, with the Ace of Cups, especially if you feel like you are, like, quote unquote, like, attractive, or, because let's be honest, you could, hey, everybody has an ego. Nobody, really, to me, nobody's, like, ugly. People just aren't. It's that beauty is in the eye of the beholder, but personally for me, nobody is, like, ugly to me, but even if you, because you could feel like, for, I don't, like, you could even have, like, it's an unconventional beauty as well, but it's something to where you are, like, attractive, and you could even question, like, how attractive, like, you were at one point in time, or, like, even, like, your own worth. But I feel like you were supposed to see, like, through that. You were supposed to learn some sort of, like, lesson beyond, like, being, like, rejected. And you could have been being rejected since you were, like, young. Or, like, the feeling of that since you were, like, really, really young, because I feel like it was a lesson to be learned from that, to where you actually are very, very gifted. Someone is. And it's with relaying messages. It's with speaking. It's with helping. Like, someone has a very helping, healing aura and energy about them to where they were blessed with it. It was a gift. It didn't just come out of nowhere. Someone was actually sent here to work as an active like guide. And I feel like a lot of times, I feel like the lesson overall, if you're questioned about like why people act like they don't like you, or they get jealous, or you know, you start to question like your worth, or you just start to feel rejected, is because these people are not ready to heal. These people are not ready to hear what you kind of like have to say. This is like going into a club trying to preach God all day. Like, them people are there to drink and party, not be preached to. You get what I'm saying? And that's kind of like the example. And whereas though, when you go around certain individuals, you don't even really have to talk. Your aura, your energy kind of speaks for itself, and it freaks these people out because they know that they're going to have to, especially these people want to maintain like in your energy, in your aura. These people know there's some level of growth that has to be done, and if they're not ready for it, they will either like pull away from you or act like they're not interested. Like some people that's not ready for you will flip the script and make it seem like they're not interested in you, when really they know they're not ready or ready for you. To where, especially in a love situation, I need somebody to really understand, especially if like people made it seem like you were too much, or what you were asking for was too much. It's never too much. These people don't, certain individuals are just not ready to grow. And you can tell they're not ready to grow the moment they really flip it on you and make it seem like you're asking too much, you're doing too much, you're expecting too much. No, you're just not ready for what I'm ready for. You're not mature enough for what I'm, you know, ready for, basically. And that's kind of like the vibe. And even through like friendship, you're just really, really here to like really, really help people, especially with this Queen of Swords. You are a no-nonsense type of person, and you're going to really... Because with the Seven of Swords, the Two of Cups, with the Queen of Swords, you could have been met with a lot of like opposition. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. People who, like, your blade was sharpened from a very, very young age, and I feel like it's still going to like continue to be like sharpened. Because I feel like there's something with just your intellect, your intuition. Someone can have really, really nice blue eyes. Someone's favorite color can honestly be blue. It's something about turquoise as well, and burgundy. Someone could wear like really, really dark lipstick as well, but it's also something about the color burgundy. Yeah, but I feel like it was something about someone like being like crossed, manipulated, like betrayed, even with the Seven of Swords, Two of Cups, with the Queen of Swords, to where even if you're not a Queen of Swords, you were pushed into this energy, because I believe that's the only queen, only real energy out here right now. Like, you had to learn a lot of harsh lessons about like people, real life situations, real life people. Know that like your upbringing was different from Kenny's, Billy's, and Bobby's. So it's like you have to, it's almost like you're learning people at the same time, and learning that people have their own trials and tribulations. And a lot of times people, like, the way people react to you has, like, there's a lot, I feel like you're about to like learn. Like, a lot of times, especially when people come at you or like say mean things to you, a lot of time it has nothing really to do with you. It has a lot to do with like that other set person. Like, someone's about to learn a lot of lessons. It's because you're supposed to learn to teach, like moving forward, to heal people. Someone's going to be like an amazing like counselor, especially like a kids counselor, a relationship counselor, a teacher, like even like a lawyer. Like, someone would be good like being a cop, a firefighter, like someone in like real, real high like position. Someone's that's meant to like guide people, help, protect. Like, someone's going like, what, especially if you want to go into any of those career fields, I would honestly say do it. And you have people really, really nervous that you're starting to see like right through like certain antics people can't do around you, because you're going to like call them out, or you're going to notice it. I'm hoping this is like making sense. What's the Seven of Swords, Two of Cups, with the Queen of Swords? Like, people know they can't like get over on you, especially with love relationships. Friend, literally, with the Empress, with the Ace of Wands. And I literally just said the Queen of Swords is the only real energy out here. And the Empress is clarifying the Seven of Swords, the Two of Cups, with the Queen of Swords. You got the Empress. Taurus, Libra energy out here. Heavy Libra. You're very smart. Someone's, you can have Libra heavy in your chart, especially like your North Node. Like, someone's meant to speak, use their intellect. Yeah, with the two you were chosen for. What's this? Ten of Cups, Eight of Wands, literally. You got the Ten of Cups clarifying the Ten of Cups with the Eight of Wands with the Five. You were meant to speak to a large amount of people, a lot, like the masses. You are also meant to like change the way people see something being like done. Like, you're going to be like the first male to do something in a like a female predominant like field, or the first female woman, excuse me, to do something in like a guy's predominantly like this. Y'all know what I'm trying to say. This message is a lot. You got the Six of Wands. But you were chosen for this. This, I feel like in this lifetime, I'm hoping this is just, cause this is new for me. I've never even really, cause I feel like this is a little deeper than what I'm used to, child. So I'm trying to make sure I read it right. But yeah, someone is supposed to like change the way people see something. Change the way like how a certain culture like it's like perceived as well. Like someone is about to change the way people look at something completely. Completely. But they were chosen to do this. What's this Three of Wands with the World? You got the Hierophant and you got the Ten of Wands. What's the Hierophant and the Ten of Wands? You got Taurus energy out here. You got the, yeah, somebody's about to be extremely busy with some sort of job opportunity they're going to get. Especially if you are trying to have like a business or you're trying to get like a promotion. Somebody is about to be like really, really busy. A lot of clientele as well, literally with the World. When the Seven of Cups, I cut it open. What's this Hierophant? Can I get one more for the Hierophant? Well, you got the Ace of Swords. Someone speaks like a lot of truth. Someone sees it. Like it's, it. I can't even, what's this Two of Pentacles? Because I feel like it's so much more to say, they're just not giving it to me. Like I can feel there's so much more to say, but they're just not giving it to, literally with the moon. We got the Five of Discs and the Moon. Something is supposed to be a surprise. You got Cancer, Pisces energy with that moon at the bottom. What's this Two of Pentacles with the Five of Discs? Yeah, you got the Nine of Swords. And the Seven of... Yeah, I feel like someone... Like someone's really protected to the point where I feel like something was supposed to alter someone. Someone's like reality. Like someone could have been through something a little traumatic, especially like in their youth. Or even as like adulthood, or even like in their teenage years, but someone was supposed to go through something pretty traumatic. You can still label it as traumatic. But someone was so protected that some, like, I don't, like it's so, like, and I feel like your spirit guides, God is screaming out to you, like, believe in yourself. You, I have you, trust me, like, let me, God, like something. And it's being shown to you over and over and over again through like different conflicts, especially if you have like family issues, friend issues, like a lesson is being shown to you over and over and over again. And it's about like trust, believing in like yourself, believing that there is a God, like believe in me. Like it's almost like a believe in me. I'm putting you through all these trials and tribulations. I'm making you see different things. I'm making you come out on top of a lot of situations that where a lot of these other people that was messing with you been through, they were not going to be able to come out on this other side. You have to trust me, believe in me. And I feel like you will, or you already like are like, and people are seeing this as well. I feel like that's what that Nine of Swords like is. Because there could have been a thing again where you could have, yeah, with the Death, you went through an amazing like transformation, like something, your whole life is like a lesson, I feel like. Like, and I know you're going to be like, I'm going to learn lessons my whole day. That's kind of what this message is. It's something about, what's this Ace of Swords? It's so much more I feel like I'm supposed to be saying. Yeah, with the Six of Pentacles. And you have the Death coming out. I feel like somebody's going to tell you something too, because it's something about the truth setting someone free. With this Ace of Swords, the Six of Pentacles, with the Death. Could be a Scorpio. What's this Four of Cups with the Four of Wands? Clarify this one more time with the Three of Wands as well. What's this Nine of Pentacles with the Nine of Cups? You got the Prince of Wands. Yeah, you got the sun that's in it. Yeah. I don't know if someone's like worried about like their future or like how something's gonna like pan out. You're gonna be okay with the Princess of Wands. What's this Ten of Discs with the Sun? Yeah, you had the Two of Swords. You can have uncertainty of like how, especially if you want to like create like a business or go, yeah, with the Lovers. It's something in communications. It's something with you talking or honestly being like your own entrepreneur. Yes, trust it. You're going to be like okay with the Three of Discs. I feel like you're going to get enough clientele. You're going to be popular for something. And it might not even be like what you really want. You actually might really be worried about if something's going to be successful. It is. It is. It is. Something is like someone is going to be doing something for a very long time. And I feel like it does have to do with like communication, speaking. What's this guy card? Yeah, you got the Princess of Swords. You're being watched by your guides, passed on loved ones, even with this guide, the Page of Swords with the Six of Cups. People that have watched you grow up since you were a baby, a child. With the Devil. Of course, he's there, right? With the Ten of Swords. He feels defeated, right? Got Capricorn energy with that and Gemini. What's the Ace of Pentacles with the Star? You got the Tower coming up. Heavy Aquarius energy. What's this Ace of Pentacles Star with the Tower? You got the King of Pentacles. You could be a Capricorn Taurus Virgo. Yeah, somebody's going to be like very shocked at like how like gifted they are in something. Like something's going to bring someone a lot of attention, a lot of money, a lot of support. What's this Tower to the King of Pentacles? You got the Three of Swords with the Ace of Wands. You do have people hurt by this as well, this change. Because I feel like it's something, yeah, with the Six of Wands, like you have people who not doubted you, but didn't see this, especially a Leo, didn't see this change. Like people feel like they didn't see like something coming for you. Like these are people who thought like they had like you figured out, like especially where your life was like headed. These people like predicted like what type of jobs you were going to get, the way you were like basically going to be living like your life. You have certain individuals who are actually butthurt because they do see some sort of new beginning coming for you. Some sort of fresh start. What's this Eight of Pentacles with this Two of Swords? Yeah, you got the Prince of Discs. What's this Eight of Pentacles with the Two of Swords with the Prince of Discs? You got the Justice, the Temperance card coming out with the Prince of Swords, and you also have the Queen of Discs. These are people who are also seeing that like they can no longer like breadcrumb you. Like I don't. It's almost like just put some respect on my name. Like these people, you have certain people from your past. It's something you kind of have to realize. Like you are a lot more powerful, a lot more. Yeah, with the Seven of Cups, you have a lot more options than what you're like giving us, than what you're able to even like see. Like you, what is it? You're not doubting yourself, but it's some sort of way. It stems from like youth or the way people treated you. I feel like, cause you have someone from the pit. There is an energy here. I'm not gonna lie. Could be an Aquarius, a Leo, could be a Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. Aquarius, if I didn't say that already, there is someone seeing this change in you that they're seeing you realize like how, your worth, that like you are like you're blessed, like no one can like control any like this is so like not creepy, but it's wild because this was someone, these were people who were feeling like. They could like belittle you. These are people who really don't like themselves. They really don't feel like God is like with them. Y'all, it's so much I feel like I have to say, and it's not coming out. Like someone's really blessed. Like someone's really blessed with like some sort of like way of like seeing, speaking. And it's with like tarot cards, like I'm gonna keep it a buck. Like someone's really gifted. Like really gifted. And I feel like someone had like people that knew this and seen it. Like especially when it came to like intuition. Especially if you caught people like in like lies, like you would tell people like, you know, I know this or I feel this or I don't feel like this person's telling, like people in your, in different environments knew that you had some sort of intuition. Like you could not at one point in time knew like intuition could be considered like a psychic. Like, cause these same people that like knew you were like intuitive, seeing other like intuitive people. Like these are people who do go to get like readings and different things like that. To where like, I feel like you were placed wherever you are, like you were the first person, like people knew face to face that has like this intuition type of thing going on. I hope that like makes sense. Like you were the first like real life tarot reader people get to like meet and see and like know and like really figure out like different, like you're going to change the way like people perceive like different things, whether it's readings, whether it's some way of like doing some sort of like job. But I feel like someone's very blessed. Someone was placed in a very, in a place where like a lot of healing needs to be like taking place, and you'll know who like kind of like accepts that or not, because they're going to like discard you. They're going to act like you don't matter. They're going to act like you're not, they're going to reject you. And those are people who are not ready to do the healing, to do the elevating. I hope that made like sense. I'm gonna get some last few cards. I'm gonna get some endings and ending messages. You got the Wheel of Fortune. This was different from this one, but yeah. You got the Wheel of Fortune, you got the King of Cups, and you got this. Could trust your intuition, literally. You got the Hangman at the bottom. Heavy Pisces energy, but you also got Cancer and Scorpio. With this Wheel of Fortune and King of Cups with the Six of Swords, you are being guided. Listen to your intuition. You could be a water sign, but you don't have to be. But with this King of Cups, you're being guided. You're being guided. Literally, with the Fool coming out, you got the Fool. You got the Prince of Cups. You have... Wait, hold on, because it didn't come out like that. You got the Fool, the Prince of Cups, the Devil with the Five of Cups, with the Eight of Pentacles. And I honestly want to say, continue to listen to your intuition, because you are being guided from people who are codependent, especially who are codependent on your energy. They're codependent on you. These are people who love your healing energy, but don't want to fully heal. They want to basically suck you dry of any and everything that you are willing to give them, whether it is money, but really energetically. And I will also stay away from people that just want to see how you're like living as well, because it's something where people just want to be connected to you, to just see what you got going on, see how you're living, who's in your life, who's not in your life. Like, it's very nosy people. These people are very, very infectious. You are like an angel to people. Halle Bailey, angel, that just came, like you are literally, you're beautiful to individuals, and especially to the end, because I want you to really understand the individuals that ever pushed you away, played with you, put you in third parties, made you feel like you had to chase, guess, run, whatever, for them, they're very intimidated by you. They did all that because they knew that they, if they sat in a room long enough for you to really get to know them, you would not like them. Like the main people that wanted you to chase them or validate them, they are the same ones again that know if you sat long enough with them, you would really not even like them. So they felt like they had to play all these games to kind of keep you interested, to get your attention, but it was really low vibrational. You were never low vibrational. You were just a victim to like your circumstances. If that kind of makes sense. And overall, these people see you elevating. You're getting kind of like away from them. You're trusting like your inner self, your inner voice. And yeah, you're definitely being guided. Someone's definitely being guided by like their intuition. Someone's definitely gifted. Yeah. But what's this Devil card? You got Capricorn energy out here. You got and this person could be a fire sign. A Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, could even be an Aries, a father figure. This is somebody who is, you are chosen. This is somebody who like really wanted like some sort of like power in a situation, power over you. And again, this doesn't even have to be like a lover. This could be anyone. These were just people overall that didn't want you to like see your worth in general. And again, these are people who really wanted to still remain under like your thumb for just like your healing energy, your voice. Like it, you, as much as people act like they don't want to be around you, trust me, people like love and like adore you. So much so that like that love that they have for you turns into like hate, because they hate the fact that they admire you so much. They hate the fact that they love you honestly just that much. And a lot of them hate the fact that like, especially if you change, like especially if you are starting to, you're breaking away, you're starting to realize, okay, me trusting in myself, me doing X, Y, and Z is actually working out for me. Let me pull away from this person. Let me trust myself. Like people are really getting offended by it. They really, really are. People are really getting offended by you stepping into your power. And I really want you to know that continue to do that. No matter if you're a woman or a man, no matter the age, no matter what, take your power back in whatever situation you are in, because you are definitely being very, very guided to have like a prosperous future, a business or family life. Like something is destined for you to like have. You're meant to like be happy doing something that was gifted to you. Like something is yours that these people like wanted. They seen you were good at something and they wanted, and they thought like being like malicious to you or like trying to stall out this opportunity was going to like, it was going to be granted like with them. Like that's kind of like what these people like thought. Like I don't know. They thought like if you miss like the boat, then that same boat will come back around for like them, and then they will like have like your spot or this gift or this talent when they weren't like born with it. But y'all, I definitely do hope the messages resonate with y'all, and I definitely do hope the messages are useful. And until next time, guys.